Hello students, I am Dr. Gajendra Purohit and I upload videos for Engineering Mathematics, B.Sc. on my YouTube channel. If you are preparing for any competitive exam, where higher mathematics is asked, my channel is very helpful for you. And through this iTab, you can check out my videos on topics like linear algebra, real, complex, modern, ODE, PDE and vector calculus. You will find the link in the description box of all these videos. And today I am going to explain the concept of reducible to linear equations in first order, first degree. And I have previously uploaded a lot of content on the first order, first degree. And I am re-uploading new content again so that you can be benefited more. You can watch the previous videos here or from the link in description. Let's discuss the reducible to linear differential equations. And what do we have to do if any reducible to linear differential equation is given? Then I had explained that in any given equation, if P and Q are functions of X and Y appears only once, then it is linear in Y. But if X also appears twice and Y also appears twice, then we will face a difficulty that how to solve this. So we can solve such questions using the concept of reducible to linear. And the first form of a reducible to linear equation is that if we have any function given here fy, and this is its derivative, and dy by dx, p and q are given. So this equation is reducible to linear in y. Let me tell you one more thing here. If we have x here, for example, let's say this is dx by dy, right? And here it is given plus p, and this is given as function of x here, is it clear? This is equal to q, and its derivative is coming here, right? So we can reduce this equation to linear. You don't need to do anything. Just consider the function to be equal to v. And this term in front will become dv by dx. Sorry, it will be dv by dy. And we will get this as linear in v, right? I will give you an example and I will try to clarify it with that. For example, students, look at this question. What is given here? It is given dy by dx. And plus, this will be x and sine 2y, which I can write as 2 sine y. Cos y and is equal to, it is given as x cube cos square y. You can observe that x function is given twice and y function is also given twice, right? And whenever we reduce to linear, if it is dy by dx, then y should come only once and not in here. In that case, what we will do? We will divide the entire equation by cos square y. And when we divide the equation, then we will get 1 upon cos square y, right? Dy by dx plus this will be x into 2 sine y. Cos of y divided by cos square y is equal to x cube. You can notice that this cos y cancels out with cos y, and on reversing this cos becomes sec square y dy by dx, and plus this will be 2, and here we will get tan y x is equal to x cube. You can observe that if you will differentiate this, then we are getting that here, clear? Its derivative is coming here. That means what we will do now? We can assume it tan v, right? So here we will write, let tan v is equal to, I am sorry, it will be tan y. So tan y is equal to v. You can observe we will get sec square y. dy by dx is equal to, here we will get dv by dx on this side. Now in place of sec square y, dy by dx we will put dv by dx. And then students, here it will become minus 2v plus 2vx. Then is equal to, here we will get x cube. And we can observe that this differential equation is linear in v. P is 2x. The value of q is x cube. We will find out its integrating factor. E to the power integration of 2x, which is p dx. When you integrate it, you will get x square by 2. So we get e to the power x square, and this is linear in v. The value of v dot if is equal to, we will get this as integral of if dot q dot dx, and it will be plus c. Now we are getting the value of vif, I am sorry, it will be v e to the power x square is equal to, it is e to the power x square, the value of q is x cube. And here I will write x cube as x square into x dx so that it becomes easier to solve. When you will do the integration of x square, then you have to assume x square is equal to p so that this 2x dx will become dp, which means on simplifying x dx would become dp divided by 2, right? Let me write with a different color here. This will be as it is, that is v e to the power x square. We will change here because we have to integrate. This will be e to the power p, as we have put p in place of x square. And this will be dp by 2 plus c. And we know that 1 by 2 will be taken out. V e to the power x square equals to 1 by 2. And integration will be done through I late. Then we know we will leave p, then this, and its differentiation is 1. And if we will do it twice, this will be plus c, and wherever it is v, you can put the value of v. And we assume the value of v as the sec square y. Sorry, it is tan y. I'm sorry. We assumed the value of v as tan y. So you can substitute this value again here. And then tan y e to the power x square is equal to, we will cross multiply this 2. That will be better. And this value of p, it is x square. E to the power x square minus e to the power x square plus 2c as 2 is multiplied. We will get this as the answer. In this way, you can solve this type of differential equation. Now let's do another question. Let's say we have this question given, right? And solving this question becomes difficult for the students, but I will explain the method to solve this type of question very easily. First, multiply e to the power x minus y with inner terms. This is e to the power x minus y, and since it is multiplied, it becomes plus x. Minus e to the power x minus y, because we will multiply this, the power will add here. We know that dy by dx is equal to, we will get the value, e to the power 2x minus y. So I can write this as e power minus y. Y is getting cancelled, so it will become e to the power x. Now take this to the other side. Now dy by dx, and it will be plus e to the power x is equal to, this will be e to the power 2x, e to the power minus y. We will multiply with e to the power y because we don't need e to the power minus y. I will multiply here, and then we will get plus e to the power x and e to the power y. This will be e to the power 2x. We can observe that we are obtaining its derivative here, right? And when we get its derivative here, we can take this as v. Let e to the power y as v and differentiate with respect to x. So we will get dy by dx and is equal to dv by dx. And the value of this, which we will get here, what we will get, students, it will be dv by dx. And plus e to the power x into v is equal to e to the power 2x. You can observe this equation is linear in v. We know that value of p is e to the power x. And the value of q is e to the power 2x. And now we will find the integrating factor, which will be e power integration of e to the power x dx. Its integration will be e to the power x. We know that whenever we have a linear differential equation given, and let me tell you that if you want to learn about linear, then you can watch my video through ITAB or through link in description. Here v.if, which is e to the power x, is equal to if.q. The value of q is this, and I can write e to the power 2x as e to the power of x into e to the power of x dx. Clear? What can we take this e to the power x as? I will take this e to the power x as p. So we know the integration of e to the power x dx, and it is equal to dp, right? Because we have to integrate this, so we will need it. So wherever it is e to the power x, put it as p. So x will become p, and here it will be dp, right? So now when we will integrate both sides, we will get v, and we had assumed v as e to the power y. This is e to the power y. It will become e to the power x, and its integration will be p e to the power p minus e to the power p plus c. We applied the Eilat rule. What is the formula of Eilat? If you have to do integration of p e to the power p dp, what we will do? We will leave p and take e to the power p minus. And the term left here, it will be differentiated. We will again do the integration of e to the power of p. Then integration of the whole term, this is the concept. We will get this value on solving. This will be e to the power x. And what is the value of p? E to the power x. We will write it. E to the power x minus. It will be e to the power x plus c. And you can also remove e to the power x. That means you can divide it here. So this will become e to the power x minus 1 plus c minus e to the power x. Therefore, we will get this answer. And in this way, we can solve this type of equation here. Clear? Now I will discuss Bernoulli equation. It is actually a type in the reducible to linear equation. And it has a particular form, which is dy by dx plus py is equal to qy to the power n. We will divide this y power n here because ultimately we have dy by dx. P and q are functions of x, and y is given twice. We will remove this from here. And when we remove y from here, when it is in terms of the power of y, earlier we had a function like e to the power x and cos was given. And here we must have it in terms of y, or if I talk about dx by dy. Then let us say we are given dx by dy and plus px is equal to, it must be qx to the power n. So we will divide it by x to the power n. And then we reduce it to linear in x. So these two forms are Bernoulli equations, and in this way we solve them, right? Let's say we have x to the power n here. The way to solve this is to divide it. And when we will divide it, then we will get dx by dy plus this will be p. X divided by x to the power n is equal to q. Then it will be n dx by dy. Plus this will come px to the power. Here we have the value that will be minus n. It will become plus 1 because it will go above, right? And this is equal to q here. And you can assume it as v. Then we will get dv by dx and the entire differential equation will reduce to linear in terms of v. Now I will give you an example from that. You will understand the whole concept more clearly. Now look at this question. We have this question and you are being asked to solve it. So students, you are asked to solve this question here. Now let's see. This is a type of Bernoulli form here. It is y square and y given. First, we need to make the coefficient of dy by dx as 1. When we will make the coefficient 1, we will divide it by x. Then we will get y square, log x by x, now divide this y square. So it becomes 1 upon y square dy by dx plus 1 divided by xy is equal to, we will get log x by x. We will assume this 1 upon y as t, or let's assume it as v, and we will take its derivative with respect to x. So it will be minus 1 upon y square. Dy by dx is equal to dv by dx. The differentiation of 1 upon y is minus 1 upon y square. We will put this value, since the minus will go there. This is minus dv by dx, because we have a plus here, so we will take minus on the other side. Plus this will become v by x is equals log x upon x. Take minus on the other side. When we take the minus to the other side, it will become minus v by x and minus log x upon x on the right side. And we know the value of p will be minus 1 upon x. And the value of q will be minus log x upon x. Now we will integrate this. We will find its integrating factor. So students, minus 1 upon x is p dx and value of p is given minus 1 by x. So this will be e to the power minus log x. This minus will go above. It will become e to the power log x inverse. That is x inverse, and we know its integrating factor will be 1 upon x. Now, since this is linear in V, then our answer will be V dot IF is equal to IF dot Q. And IF is 1 upon x and Q is minus log x upon x. Then I will take the minus out. We will get the value 1 by x log x upon x dx plus C. Now what we will do here? We have log x. We will assume it as T, right? Or let's assume it as P, right? Let log x is equal to P. You can observe this 1 by x. Dx will be equal to dp in this case, right? We will get dp. This will become v by x. You can notice it will be minus. And let me tell you, this 1 upon x dx will become dp here. Log x will become p, but 1 upon x is causing difficulty. Let me tell you, when we assume log x as p, then x becomes e to the power p. This will be 1 upon e to the power p plus p, right? As the value of x is e to the power c. This will be v by x minus, this will be e to the power minus p, p dp plus c. And Eilat method will be used, which I used in the previous question. We will put that minus here. Now what will we do? P is left and it will be minus p, e to the power minus p. The derivative of this will be 1. And we will do it twice, then it will be the same. So this will be e power minus p plus c. We will put the value of v here. We took the value of v as 1 upon y. So this will become 1 upon xy, and this minus will go inside and it will become plus. We assumed p as log of x. And because here it is e to the power minus p, it is x. So then minus p, it will be 1 upon x here, minus and minus will be plus. This will also be 1 by x plus c. Now we will multiply this by x, then we will get 1 upon y. This will be equal to log x plus 1 and here plus cx. So we will get the answer here. And in this way, this type of differential equation can be solved. Now look at this question. You can try this because it is very easy. You can solve this question easily by dividing it with y to the power 6. Let me take another question. Now this question is given. Xy plus x cube y cube. And it is multiplied by dy by dx is equal to 1. Suppose we have this differential equation given here. And you are asked to solve this question. We can solve this question easily. We will take dx by dy to the other side, right? So when we take dx by dy to the other side, then we will get xy here and plus x cube y cube. I am changing this question. You can solve this one. I will solve this question as I will explain the concept of reducible to linear in x. Now we will take this xy to the other side and then we will get dx by dy minus xy is equal to, here we will get x cube y cube. You can observe this is dx by dy here. In this case, we will divide it by x cube, and when we will divide it by x cube, then we will get 1 upon x cube. Here it will be dx by dy and minus 1 upon x square, and it will be equal to y cube. Is it clear? Now we will assume 1 divided by x square as t. So write let 1 upon x square as v. If we will assume it as v, and then we will find its derivative. So this will be minus 2 upon x cube dx by dy is equal to dv by dy. We will do its cube with respect to y, right? So here it will be 1 upon x cube. The value of dx by dy here, it will be equal to dv upon minus 2 dy. Then we can substitute this value in the expression. And now, what value we will get? The value we will get will be dv upon minus 2 dy. And at this point, we will have minus yv, and it will be equal to y cube. What is the next step? We will multiply this minus 2. We will get this as dv by dy and minus 2, and yv will be multiplied, so it will be plus 2. Yv is equal to minus 2y cube. And now this will be the value of p and this will be the value of q, right? Since this is linear in v, so p will be 2y and the value of q will be minus 2y cube. We will find its integrating factor. We know the integrating factor is p dy. And p is 2y, this will become e to the power of y square, right? Since this is linear in v, this will be v dot if. And then here we will get is equal to if dot q. The value of q is y cube. I will take the minus outside and I will write this y cube as y square and 2y dy, right? Consequently, we will get 2y cube and minus here. So we can write it in this way, and I simplified it like this to make it easier in solving. Now take y square as t, or let's assume y square as p here. And you can notice that 2y dy is equal to, we will get dp. And now we will get v into e raised to the power y square. Keep this minus as it is here. It will be e to the power p. And it will be p dp, and here it will be plus c. Don't forget this c when we integrate it. You can take e to the power y square outside. We kept p as it is and integrated e to the power p. So we will get e to the power p plus c. Now what we will do? Wherever it is v, put the value of v, which is 1 by x square. This will be e to the power y square upon x square is equal to minus will go inside and p is y square. This will be minus y square. E to the power y square, and it will become plus e to the power y square plus c. Now you can divide it by e to the power y square. Then we will get 1 upon x square, and here minus y square plus 1 plus c e to the power minus y square. So what will be this value? It will be the answer. It is reducible to linear in x. Before this, the equation was reducible to linear in y. And students, you can try to solve it by dividing by y to the power 6. Then we will assume 1 upon y to the power 5 as v. As a result, we will get dv by dx. And you can solve this question in this way. I have just solved many questions here, and I want you guys to try it now. You have to tell me the answer in the comment box how we will solve this question, and let me know how long it took you to solve this question. The videos of differential equation, which I had uploaded. If you want to watch those videos, all of them are available here. And you can check out the new playlist where I have uploaded new content from here, and my channel where I upload many short tricks. You can check that channel and you can subscribe to it, and do follow me on Instagram. Thank you so much for watching. Do like, share and subscribe to the channel. And please give me the answer of this question in the comment box and let me know how many seconds it took you to solve this question. Thank you. Bye bye, students.